I am Dr. Hadi, a senior lecturer from University Malaysia Sabah. Today topic is first aid treatment for bee sting and anaphylaxis. At the end of this module, you are going to learn difference between allergic reaction and anaphylactic reaction, bee insect bite and sting. Furthermore, you will learn how to do first aid treatment for anaphylaxis and step-by-step use of EpiPen. At the end, how to reduce chances of being bee stung will be taught. Common allergens include bee or insect venom, antibiotics, pollen, animal dander, sulfur, and some foods such as nuts, peanuts, shellfish, strawberries, and coconut oils. At first, the mild reaction may appear to be just a rash. But this condition can become life-threatening severe allergic reaction, which is called anaphylaxis. During anaphylaxis, the person's face, neck, and tongue may swell, closing the airway. Air passages swell and restrict a person's breathing. The person also may feel dizzy, confused, tightness in the chest and throat, or low blood pressure. Anaphylaxis can be brought on immediately within seconds or minutes when a person with an allergy comes into contact with any allergens. Call ambulance if victim is subject to severe allergic reactions in the past, unconscious, or has trouble breathing, throat tightening. Please prescribe antihistamine and hydrocortisone as soon as possible. Asthma inhaler can help with coughing and wheezing. Epinephrine is called adrenaline that is put in EpiPen, which is a life-saving medication used for anaphylactic reaction. If you have been prescribed EpiPen for an anaphylactic reaction, always carry two with you and use it as directed. Normally, one dose could relieve the symptoms. Patient or family member should be taught about self-injection technique of EpiPen. It should be used when a person is suspicious of anaphylactic reactions, such as having trouble breathing, tightness in the throat, lightheadedness. There are different doses for young children versus older children and adults. Making a fist. The end with the orange tip contains the needle and should be facing down. Use your other hand to pull off the blue safety release. If you are giving the injection to a child, hold leg firmly in place. Step 3. Against the outer thigh until it clicks so that the unit is perpendicular to the thigh. Hold in place for at least 2 to 3 seconds to allow all of the medicine to be injected. Massage the injected area for seconds. Adverse effects of epinephrine. You might feel pounding heartbeat, fleeting chest pain, nervousness, headache, nausea, and so on. The auto-injector should not be thrown away in the normal trash. Please take the used auto-injector with you to the hospital emergency department so that it can be disposed of safely. Some people know that they are allergic to certain substances or to insect stings. They may have learned to avoid these things and may carry medication and EpiPen to reverse the allergic reaction. People who have severe allergic reactions may wear a medical identification tag, bracelet, or necklace. Tell the doctor or nurse that you had anaphylaxis before. What are the differences between insect bite and sting? Insect bite use its mouth parts so that can transfer blood from other people and animals that they've bitten to you. However, insect sting inject venom too that can irritate your skin. Therefore, insect stings can be deadly to people who are severely allergic to the insect venom. You can feel presence of stinger in your skin, pain around the sting area, swelling, and some allergic reactions sooner after the bee sting. First aid treatment for bee sting include: remove any stingers immediately after being stung. Apply ice around the area to remove pain and swelling. Rub the ice in a towel or keep a cloth between the ice and skin to keep from freezing the skin. Take an anti-allergic medication such as antihistamine to reduce itchiness and swelling. Painkillers such as paracetamol to reduce the pain. After washing the sting site with soap and water, place hydrocortisone cream on the stung area that will help to relieve redness, itching, and swelling. Take a tetanus booster dose if it has been more than 10 years. There are several precautions can be taken to reduce chances of insect bite or stung. 1. Wear shoes, long sleeve shirts, and long pants when you go outside. 2. Wear light colors to reduce attracting the bees. 3. Wear bug spray. Stay inside at dawn and dusk, when mosquitoes are most active. 4. Drain areas of standing water near your home, such as wading pools and buckets. 5. If you live in an area that has fire ants, avoid stepping on ant mounds. 7. If you find an insect nest in or near your house, call a pest control service to get rid of the nest safely.